one of the other big megatrends is, of course, nanotechnology. And that means a lot of things to a lot of people. But I think, simply stated, it's how do you, you know, what materials work to produce certain components? You know, components need to be have a certain stress tolerance. They need to have a certain weight. And they need to have a certain cost. Historically, we've thought, well, you make things out of steel or you make things out of plastic. Now we're moving to producing parts that are actually way less, cost less, and are stronger out of aluminum than some of those traditional products. That's a simplistic example of nanotechnology. I think if you think about the science of redirecting molecules to make certain materials actually much stronger, and stronger, lighter, cost competitive, but also the functionality of those materials, all of a sudden creates an incredibly enormous opportunities for companies to make new products that heretofore would have been too expensive. Now, because of the nanotechnology and the molecular structure of some of these materials, these products can be made better, cheaper, certainly faster, but also they can be made. You don't have to go mine the iron ore to produce the product. Some of these things are literally made in the scientists' labs.
One of the interesting things about working in these industries is technology is getting embedded in the product in new and different ways. You know, if you look at some of the more recent airframe launches that have new use of composites, new production capabilities and techniques, overall new innovations in design, the technology element of product is accelerating. And that coupled with the customer influence around their power and interest in product design, that congruence of technology and customer are transforming how companies have to go about designing and launching product. They have to be much more agile, much more collaborative with people outside the organization and across the organization, and frankly, a lot more innovative in thinking about new ideas and new ways to tap ideas and knowledge beyond the four walls of the traditional R&D department.
Well, I think in any manufacturing sector, it's really, what products do you have? Are they what the customer want? Are they better than your competitors? Are they lower cost competitors? And can you get them to the market faster? Things like nanotechnology are tremendously accelerating the pace of innovation, new product development, the idea, you know, moving from the ideation to the actual production of the product. You know, companies now are saying, well, if I can use this material and I can use this process and I can make this part, maybe I have an enhancement to an existing, you know, product that I already make that might actually make my product more desirable to the customer than one of my competitors. So it's really influencing. I mean, certainly it's influencing the kinds of products that get made, but it's really critical in driving the innovation process and, you know, kind of restating to a manufacturer the art of the possible. What can I do with my product today? How do I enhance it? And nanotechnology is one of the key components to making, you know, more innovative, more relevant, more customer-oriented, stronger, cheaper, you know, products for the benefit of the customer.